In this video, we're computing the magnetic field at the center of a uniformly charged rotating disk. So here's our disk with a radius of big R, total charge big Q, and angular speed omega. And the idea for the problem is that we're going to use our previous result for the magnetic field at the center of a rotating ring of charge. So there's the previous result we're given for the rotating charged ring. The magnetic field turned out to be mu naught Q omega over 4 pi R. And I'll post a link to the video where that result was derived. So the strategy here is that we're going to break this disk into concentric rings, find the magnetic field contribution due to each ring, and then we add up all the contributions by using an integral. But before we get started, I'd like to give a quick reminder about area charge density. So area charge density is normally notated as a lowercase sigma, and that's the charge per unit area, or Q divided by A, and it has units of coulombs per square meter. We can also turn this around, and we say that charge can always be computed by multiplying area charge density times area, or sigma times A. So we'll use that in a minute, but next we're going to break this disk into thin rings. So that's what a representative thin ring looks like. And we gave that a radius of little r to distinguish it from the disk radius, and that means the thickness of this ring is dr. So now we can write down the magnetic field contribution given by this ring by referring back to our result for the field at the center of a rotating charged ring. Now, because this contribution to the total magnetic field is infinitesimal, we're going to call it dB. So our formula was mu naught Q omega over 4 pi R, but for this little ring, the charge contribution is infinitesimal, so we're going to call that dQ. And we also write down a lowercase r down here because that's the radius of our thin ring. So now we have to figure out how to write this dQ in terms of the integration variable here, which is going to be r. And that's where this idea of area charge density comes into play. We can find dQ by taking the uniform area charge density on this disk, we'll call that sigma, and multiplying by the area captured in that thin ring. So for now, I can just call that dA. Now to get the area captured by that thin ring, we simply slice and unroll it and compute its area as a rectangle. If we unroll that thing, we get a length of 2 pi r, in other words, the circumference of the ring, and then we have a thickness of dr. So dQ can be replaced by sigma times 2 pi r dr. So making that replacement in the expression for dB, we notice that several things are going to cancel out here. So actually the little r cancels out, a factor of pi cancels out, a factor of 2 cancels out, leaving us with a 2 in the denominator. And we can clean up this whole expression as 1 half mu naught sigma omega times dr. So now that our magnetic field contribution has been written entirely in terms of one variable, that's r, which only appears in this expression as the infinitesimal dr, we can go ahead and apply integration to add up all the dBs. So what we're doing is adding up all these contributions as little r goes from 0 to big R. So that's how you build the entire disk out of nested rings. And I'm going to start as usual by writing down that the total magnetic field is the sum of all the magnetic field contributions, in other words, the integral of dB. And that's just another reminder that integration is really a summation device for adding up infinitely many infinitesimal contributions. So now we just sub in our expression for dB, and then we have to apply the limits of integration. So this time, again, we're adding up rings as we go all the way from the center of this disk at 0, all the way to the outer edge of the disk at capital R. Now this integral is trivial because everything there is constant except for dr, and when we integrate that, we just get r. Then when we evaluate across the limits of integration, the lower limit is going to give us 0, and the only survivor is capital R. So we'll just go ahead and write the final answer here as 1 half mu naught sigma omega times big R. So that's one way to write the final answer. But in this problem, we were given the total charge on the disk rather than the area charge density sigma. So we should go ahead and substitute for sigma. So going back to the definition of area charge density, the area charge density is the total charge divided by the total area of this disk. In other words, that's going to be Q divided by pi big R squared. So making that substitution, we can write our magnetic field at the center of this disk as 1/2 mu naught times Q over pi big R squared, just replacing sigma with that, times omega times big R. Now one of those big R's is going to cancel out, and I can write this whole thing as a fraction. So that's mu naught Q omega divided by 2 pi big R. So one interesting point about this result is that it turns out to be exactly twice the value we got for the rotating charged ring of radius big R. This video is part of a magnetism playlist, including a variety of Biot-Savart and Ampere's law calculations, and you can find a link to that playlist at the lower left of the end screen. Thanks for watching.